The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text 13 and 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in July 1966 in New York.
Maya system, guna karma vibhavata, sasya tattaramati, ma, Vidhi, apakaram, abhayam. This verse was being discussed in our last meeting. That there are four divisions of men in the human society. And that division is natural. That is not artificial. Because the whole material nature is working under the influence of three modes of nature, goodness, passion, and ignorance. You cannot classify the whole human race into one. So long we are in the material world, it is not possible to make everyone on the same standard. It is not possible. Because each and everyone is working under the influence of different modes of nature. Therefore, there must be division, natural division. This point we have discussed. But when we transcend this material plane, then there is one. There is no more division. So how to transcend? That transcendental nature is Krishna consciousness. As soon as we become fully absorbed in Krishna consciousness, we are transcendental to the material modes of nature. Man chabhyadicharina bhakti yogina jasevate sagunam samati paritan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. It is fine in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 14th chapter. Anyone who is fully engaged in the Krishna consciousness activity, he is at once in the transcendental position, brahma bhuyaya kalpate. We are, by nature, we are not matter, we are brahma, aham brahmasmi. The propaganda of Shankaracharya was mainly based on this understanding that we should not think that we are the products of this material nature. We are not products of material nature. It is by some accident, by freak of nature, by misfortune, somewhere or other, we are now in contact with it. But actually, I am really Brahma. So that Brahma nature has to be involved, has to be. We are actually just like a diseased person. He has to be brought into the healthy condition of life to cure the disease. So just a man, when he is diseased and when he is healthy, from external features of this state, just like I am now healthy. So my external features, I have got two hands and two legs, and the face has so many things. The same body, when I am in the disease condition, you will find the same hands, the same legs and mouth and everything, but the condition is different. I'll speak something nonsense, because the condition has changed in the disease condition. Similarly, in our disease condition. This material life is our disease condition. So when we are in the healthy condition, that is called Brahma. That is called Brahma condition. So that Brahma condition can at once be regained as soon as we engage ourselves fully, 10% in the activities of Krishna consciousness. That is clearly mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 14th chapter, you will find. Marcha ja abhyavicharena bhakti yogena sevate. Anyone who renders his transcendental loving service unto me, sa gunam samatita eta, that person immediately transcends the modes of material nature. Samatita, sama, sammak atitya, perfectly transcending samatita. Then, transcending the material nature, then he becomes zero? No, that is his real nature. Now, the philosophy which preaches that after our liberation, after nirvana of this material existence, there is zero. Oh, that is very dangerous theory. Because we are not attracted by zero. Oh, that is our nature, living entity. Now, suppose I am suffering from some disease and there are so many ailments, and if some doctor comes, oh, let me finish your ailment by killing you. Oh, will you agree? He'll say, no, no, better let me suffer from the disease. I don't want to be killed. Is it not? Will you agree? Suppose you have got too much suffering, miseries of life, and I suggest all life, let me cut your throat and kill you, and everything will be finished. Oh, no, 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 I am not agreeing to that. That is the same man's statement. Oh, I am not going to be killed for ending my misery. That is the nature. So the theory that after and let it end of all this material misery, there is nothing. Why? Oh, that is not attractive. That is not attractive at all. And that is not the fact. Real fact is that I am Satchidananda Vigraha, part and parcel of the Supreme. The Supreme Lord is Satchidananda Vigraha. And I am qualitatively one with him. I am also, although I am small, just like a particle of the sea water, that is also salty. That is also salty. The taste of a small drop of sea water is the same as the taste of the big arc, big portion of the Atlantic Ocean. So the quality is the same. Similarly, I may be small, I may be a spiritual atom. My position is that I am spiritual atom, and the Supreme Spirit is all the greatest. But that does not mean I am different from the quality. I am of the same quality. So, I am not void. Na hannate hannamayane sarire. If by frustration one commits suicide, oh, that is not the end of his misery. He creates another misery. By committing suicide. That's like here, in the state law, if somebody attempts suicide and takes some poison, and if by treatment of the physician he's all right, he's again under the law to be punished. Perhaps he's not. After curing him from that poisonous effect, is under criminal code of the state. Why he had attempted suicide? Similarly, in the laws of nature, if you commit suicide, that is another criminal act. The suicidal policy to end this misery of life is not all. We must have, greater life. In the Bhagavad Gita, I have read already, I have discussed. Param drishtya nivartate. Param drishtya nivartate. One has to end this miserable life after finding out a life of bliss and knowledge and eternity. That should be our. We should not be trying only to end this misery of life, expecting something bad. Oh, no. That's a lot. Krishna, this Chaturbandha Maya system, these divisions of human society is created by the Lord. Because to elevate ourselves from the classes of this deluding Maya or illusion. So, just like one has to be educated from the lower class to the postgraduate class. Similarly, this division of labor is there just to elevate one from the lowest stage of consciousness to the highest stage of Krishna consciousness. So, that is a cooperation. That is a cooperation. Just like my body, there are different parts of my body. The head is the most important part of my body. The next important part is my arms. The next important part is my belly. And the next important part is my legs. But although the head is the most important part of my body, there is no question of neglecting the lowest part of my body, the leg. Similarly, although there are divisions in the human society, four divisions according to the different modes of nature, the highest class is called the Brahmin, or the most intellectual class, and the next class is called the Kshatriya. There's the administrative class, and the next is the Vaishya, or the mercantile, productive class, and the next is the Sudras, or the liberal class. So all of them, they are required. But if they cooperate for Krishna consciousness, so there is no strife between these higher and lower class. We find in the present social, status of our life. We are actually existing in four divisions, but there is no cooperation. Practically, everyone dissatisfied. Take for example, the strife between the capitalist class and the laborer class. They are trying in different ways. There is no compromise. There is always friction, especially in a country like India, there is always friction, and other countries also. So they are not satisfied. Recently also, in your country also, there was strife by the bus drivers and the subway drivers and administration. So there is always strife. What? This is due to lack of Krishna consciousness. This is due to lack of Krishna. There cannot be any cooperation unless there is Krishna consciousness. The Krishna consciousness is an essential fact for harmonizing in the present material society that is required. So, Krishna Das is so important thing. Cooperation. The same example can be said here also, that the leg, the hand, and the belly, and the mouth, what they are? They are cooperating. Cooperating for what? Cooperating for maintaining this body. This is the common interest. And how it is cooperating? To supply everything to the stomach. The brain is working, earning some money, the hand is fetching something and cooking, and the mouth is chewing, and the leg is going, but the whole function is targeted to fulfill the demands of the stomach. If these parts of the body non-cooperate with the stomach, they become feeble and weak, and there will be no capacity to work. Similarly, Krishna consciousness means that, you know, whatever division I may be the Brahmin, I may be the Kshatriya, I may be the Vaishya or the Sudra, that doesn't matter. But if we cooperate for Krishna consciousness, there will be perfect peace in the world. This is a fact. So this idea of Krishna consciousness is very important factor. Although people they are unknown to this fact, although it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, in the world, Bhagavad Gita is very popular book. They are reading Bhagavad Gita. And in Dr. Radha Krishna's book, we understand that Bhagavad Gita has been so important book throughout the whole world that there is a sect in Germany who are called Indo-German religious sect. Perhaps some of you may know. They are acting and on the principle of Bhagavad Gita. So, actually, in the Bhagavad Gita, the most important part is Krishna consciousness. In every verse, in every chapter, in every conclusion, you'll find Krishna, the speaker of Bhagavad Gita, is giving a stress on his personal self. Maam hi partha pasitta jiti to maam, this maam. Maam means me, unto me. Krishna says unto me. But there are many miscreants who are interpreting this maam as everyone. As everyone. Just like when I say, I want a glass of water, does it mean that you want a glass of water? No. My individuality, I want a glass of water. But they are making my jugglery work. When I say, I want a glass of water, that means everyone wants a glass of water. Is it a fact? Similarly, when Krishna says, I, they identify with the I themselves. That is their interpretation. That is misinterpretation. Bhagavad Gita, therefore, although Bhagavad Gita is very popular in the world, due to this misinterpretation of so many scholars, they have been not properly understood. That is a fact. Bhagavad Gita explains very nicely its strength, that there is a chatubandhang maya system gunatamna jihava. That these divisions of human society into four classes, that is established by Krishna, but he is out of it. He is not one of us. He does not belong to this chatubandhang. Suppose when Krishna comes in incarnation, in his body, it does not mean that he belongs to either of these classes, either to the Brahmin, just like Krishna appeared himself as the son of Devaki or Vasudeva. Vasudeva was belonging to the royal family, Kshatriya. So Krishna played the part just like a Kshatriya. Kshatriya means administrative class. But that does not mean that Krishna belongs to a Kshatri class. It is to be understood. There are dasa avatars. There are many incarnations of Krishna. Just like the first avatar incarnation is called Matsya avatar. Pralaya paya dhijale dhitavana sivedam vihita vahitra charitrama sedam kesava dhita buddha kesava dhita meena sarira jaya jagadish hare. Kesava, Krishna appeared just like a thief. He appeared himself in the thief community. Oh, but that does not mean that he was thief. If you think of taking a thief, it is the generation of Krishna. Of course, everything is Krishna from another point of view. So similarly, Krishna, because in the previous part we have discussed that simply by knowing the transcendental nature of Krishna, one becomes liberated. See, how you can understand Krishna by his transcendental nature? That is being described in this verse. Sasya kartaramati. Sasya kartaramati mana vidhi. Although I have established this divisions of the human society into four classes, so I am not one of them. This has to be understood. But as soon as we make it a mistake that, Krishna, he appeared in the royal family of Vasudeva, so he belonged to the Kshatriya community or the administrative class. No. Then you can understand the transcendental nature of Krishna. And if you have got any doubt, you can ask, you can understand, but as soon as you understand it rightly, you become a liberated person. That is the secret. As soon as you understand the fact as it is, the transcendental nature of Krishna, step forward to a liberation. So similarly, these things are being explained one after another. The next sloka, namaṁ karmāni limpanti name karma phalestriha iti mānjo avijānāti karmabhi nasa bhagate. That's it. Namaṁ karmāni limpanti. Karmāni, just like we are acting something, anything we are doing, there is some reaction. In every action there is some reaction. Just like I am speaking here, this vibration is being recorded all over the universe. This sound, the radio message, how it is transmitted in the modern world. Similarly, as I am speaking, so whatever I am doing, that is immediately recorded. And there will be some reaction. Just like the sound vibration is react, who has got some radio machine, there is reacting. Similarly, every of any action, either good action or bad action, it will have react. That is the law of nature. So cannot be free from the reaction of my action. But here Krishna says, namaṁ karmāni limpanti. There is no reaction of the activities of Krishna. Just like Krishna was commanding over Arjuna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, and practically he was ordering that you must fight, you must kill the enemy. Now, this act of Krishna has no reaction on him. One should understand. Namam karmani limpanti. If there is any difficulty to understand, we may consult persons who are in the understanding, we may consult books, we may consult authority, that we can do. Because inquiries are always allowed. Sabdhiti panipatena pariprasnena sivaya. And the transcendental inquiry is never forbidden. With sincere purpose, one can make inquiry. But fact is this, if I cannot understand in my present condition, that is my misunderstanding. But the fact is this, that Krishna, when he comes, he is not like any one of us. He is transcendent. Neither any act which he does, it has got real. And he says, Nami karma phale sriha. I have no desire for any fruitive activity. That's right. We want to do something. Suppose I want to do some business. And what is the idea? Because I want to make some profit out of the business, and if there is sufficient profit, I shall be gainer, I shall be rich man, I shall be able to enjoy life and so on, so many things and all background. So I have my desire. Whenever I do something, we condition so, whenever I do something, there is some desire behind. And what is the desire for anyone? That's all. But Krishna says, Name karma phalasya, because he has nothing to desire. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is full with everything. Now sometimes Krishna is misunderstood, that Krishna, in his boyhood, he had so many girlfriends. Perhaps you may know who has written, gone through Krishna's life. Or in his youthhood, he married 16,000 wives. This is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. He had 16,108 wives. So, sometimes who does not understand Krishna, they think, oh, Krishna was so sensuous. He kept 16,000 wives. No. That is not the fact. What was the fact? The fact is, Krishna, the Supreme Lord, we have got different relationship with the Supreme Lord. Constitution, every one of us. The relationship as we experience in this material world, just like you are my brother, or he is my sister, or he is my father, he is my... So many relationships we have got. So all these relationships are calculated into five. They are practically, there are 12 relationships. 12 relationships are contracts against, just like you are my enemy. I want to kill you. You want to kill. That is also one of the relationships. But this is contract, this is not favor. This is called vivaksha, hasha. Something I see in you, I begin to laugh. Or something you see in me, you begin to laugh. So there are different. So altogether, there are 12 relationships in every activity of our life. Out of that, 5 relationships is very favorable. What is that? Not 5 exactly, but yes, fine. Just like I am sitting here on this bag. So I have got some relationship. What is the relationship? That this bag is giving me service silently. Thus, there is relationship. I am comfortably sitting here. So this is one relationship. The next relationship is that one wants to serve me, or I want to serve him. Out of love, I want home. Just like some of you, family, I brought some food for you. This is out of love. That means you want to serve me. So this relationship with the back, and that relationship who comes and brings for some food for me, that is higher. That is called dasha or friendship. So the silent relationship, the servitude relationship, the friendly relationship, then paternal relationship, then conjugal relationship. So these relationships which we find here in this material world, they are reflection of the original relationship with Krishna. Because in the Vedanta Sutra you find, Janmadvasyadaha, everything whichever you find in this material world, that is born from the Absolute Truth. So in the Absolute Truth, there is the relationship, these relationships which are experiencing here. But they are perverted. Perverted, because suppose I accept somebody as master and I am serving, and as soon as his salary is gone, my service is gone. That way it is perverted. And there is a girl I love, or there is a man I love, so as soon as there is some misunderstanding, it breaks. So that relationship, that conjugal relationship, that paternal relationship, that friendly relationship, just like you will find in the Bhagavad Gita, the Krishna and Arjuna, they are in relationship of friendship. Now, when Krishna says that I told this yoga, Bhagavad Gita yoga, to the sun god, say some millions of years before, and Arjuna, just to represent our interest, he says, Krishna, you are my contemporary. How is that? You spoke Bhagavad Gita 40 millions of years before to sun god. So Krishna answers that Bahuni me janmani tabutagi. Both you and myself, we have born many times, but you have forgotten. I remember. That is the distinction. Now, here you see that the friendship of Krishna is going on, not in this birth, but perpetually that friendship is there. But in the material world, the friendship exists for a few years and then breaks. That's why it is reflected. It is not real. If you make your friendship with Krishna, that will never break. If you make your master Krishna, you will never be cheated. If you love Krishna as your son, he will never die. Similarly, if you love Krishna as your lover or husband, he will be the best husband, the best lover. There will be no divorce. Very simple. So similarly, there are many, because Krishna is the Supreme Lord. He has unlimited, he is unlimited, and he has unlimited number of devotees. But some of them are trying to love him as lover or husband. Now what Krishna will do? In the previous verse we have read that Jijakharam pradatvante tāṁ sathayyo bhajāmyaham. Anyone who wants me in some sort of relationship, I accept. I accept that. So the fact is that these wives of Krishna, that is the real fact, in the previous life, they made a tremendous penance to achieve Krishna as their husband. Just like in the Bhagavad, there is a verse Sukadeva Goswami is describing. These things are very sublime things. If you kindly hear them attentively, in feel sublime pleasure, undoubtedly. In the Bhagavad, when Krishna was playing with boys, just like boys play, Krishna was playing just like a boy. So the Sukadeva Goswami describes that attitude. Ittam satana brahma sukhana bhutya dasam datanam paradevataya. The purport is that here is a thing. These boys were playing with Krishna, that for many, many lives they undergone penances to have Krishna as their playmate. Now they are enjoying that. So the playmates of Krishna, they are not ordinary persons. They underwent many, many bad tapasya, penances, just like one has to see the favor of the Supreme Lord by penances, by tapasya. So they desire like that, and Krishna has accepted our life. Come on, let us play. And what is that play? Krishna is playing with the boys, just like boys play. They say, next time one boy is defeated, so when he is defeated, he has to carry the other boy on his shoulder. So many they manufacture playing things. The same similarly, sometimes Krishna is being defeated, so he has to carry other boy on his shoulder. These things are being done. Because we have no idea of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, we take it as trifling, but Krishna's consciousness is so sublime that all perfection of our desires are there. Whatever we are desiring, whatever desires we have got, constitutionally, all those desires will be perfectly fulfilled when we are in Krishna consciousness. Okay? So Krishna, here he says, that Name Karma Phalasriha. Krishna did not require any friend to play with him. Neither Krishna had any desire of having a single wife. We require wife. Why we take the responsible wife? Because we have got some desire to fulfill. That's all. But he complete himself, Purna. A poor man can desire that, if I would have bank balance, say, $1,000 in the bank, I would have been happy. But a rich man who has got millions of dollars in the bank, does he desire for $100 in the bank? He has no such desire. Similarly, if Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, why he should have desire? For he is full. Rather, he fulfills others' desire. That is the thing. Man proposes God is full. Why God should have desire? Otherwise, he is imperfect. So Krishna has, here he says, Name Karma Phalasriha. I have no desire to fulfill because he is full. Whatever he wants, process in basic literature, fine. Prasasakti dividaiva suyate sabhaviti jnanavalakhyasa. The Supreme Brahma, he has got different diverse energy. As soon as he desires, everything is done immediately. If I have to manufacture this stand, I'll have to arrange for so many things. I'll have to go to the branch with me and ask him and give him some money and so many things. And the Parasakti, even a yogi, there is a Prapti Siddhi. You have heard the name of yoga. The yoga system is not so pleasant as we have got so many branches in America. They are pleasant. Actually, the global system is so perfect that they get eight kinds of perfection before achieving the real perfection. And what is the perfection? The eight kinds of anima, lagima, siddhi, prapti, isita, vasita, like that. Anima siddhi means when a yogi is not exactly perfect, when he is on the way of perfection, he gets this opportunity. He can become the smallest. If you pack a yogi in a room and lock it, he will come out. In Banaras, India, there was a Trailing Mathani yogi. He was sitting on the street, naked. So government took objection. Oh, you are seeing this is upset, you cannot. I will say. Then he was put into the custody. So he came out. He was locked. That is not a very old story. You say about 100 years before Trailing Mathani. So thrice, four times he was put into the custody and he came out. So this is the first siddhi, first perfection. Similarly, the yogi also, if he wants, perhaps I cited this story, in my childhood I had my teacher, and he had his spiritual master, a great yogi. So my teacher used to narrate the story of his spiritual master, that one day he went to the spiritual master, and the spiritual master asked him, well, what do you want to eat? And they replied that you want a fresh pomegranate from Afghanistan. All right, see. So, in the room, they saw a branch of pomegranate just with juice, just like somebody has snatched the branch from the tree and it is there. The yogis, they can perform such wonderful things. If I want this thing, I have to endeavor for it. But a yogi can at once make it. These are some of the preliminary perfections of yogi. So, Krishna is called Yogishvara. He is the, you'll find in the Bhagavad Gita, he is described as Yogishvara. So, he is the master of all yogic principles. So, for him, why there shall be desire for enjoyment? He is so perfect that he hasn't got to marry, he hasn't got to keep a girlfriend. He is so perfect. But this is the nature of Krishna, we have to understand. Then why he married? He married just to fulfill the desires of his devotees. Those devotees who wanted Krishna as their husband. So, he accepted. And when he played the part of a husband, he played very perfectly. Just like when he played the part of a friend, of the boy's friend, he played it very perfectly. When he played the part of a small boy, of Yashoda, he played it perfectly. Just like he was creating disturbance when he was, say, 3 years old. Just like children, two years old, they create all the disturbance is mother. They don't leave the company of mother at the same time, they create disturbance. So Krishna was doing that. Now, the mother decided, no, I shall bind you, it's wrong. You are creating so much disturbance. And she took a stick and it will create disturbance and I'll beat it. Krishna began to cry. So there is a description in the Bhagavad by Kunti that the person who is the object of frightening for everyone, he was afraid of the stick of Jagannath. What? He was perfectly playing the childhood. So this is the Krishna's life. So one has to understand this. He was not mean. Yes, that's exactly the same thing as he said. That name karma phalitya. I have no desire. I don't know why he felt a desire. He is full. Desire, a needy person has desire. Like a man who is full. why he says it is there. Namang karmani limpanti namitanno iti manjo vijanati. Now, just I try to explain a little portion of the Krishna's activity. When he appears in this world, he told his activity. Just that fact. That you are frustrated in senses. Come on, make sense with me. Oh, you are frustrated in getting a good master. Come on, serve me. I become your good master. Oh, you are frustrated in the love of your son. Oh, have me as your son. Because here we are frustrated with our sons and daughters. We expect something. But when they are grown up, they go in their own way. We are trusted. That's of Krishna as son, and he is the most obedient son, just like you are playing the part before Jesus. Similarly, accept Krishna as husband or lover, he'll never be trusted. That is the whole plan. Anything, whatever desire you have got, you can establish and in relationship with Krishna in that desire, and he'll be happy. Perfectly happy. Never to be cheated. So, namang karma, iti manjo vijanati. Anyone who understands this philosophy, this transcendental nature of Krishna, then what is the result? Karma vinasa baddhate. Because we are bound up by the reaction of our past deeds. So as soon as we understand the transcendental activities of Krishna, at once we become free from all reactions. Because I cannot understand Krishna's transcendental activities unless I am actually dotted with him. Why I shall be interested with your activities unless I have got some specific purpose? Similarly, let us develop this Krishna consciousness. And gradually we shall have that is called Swarup Siddhi. Now every living entity has got an eternal relationship with Krishna. Because we are part of just like my part and part of the body. It has got a specific relationship with my body. Just like this hand is the part and parcel of my body. It has got a specific position in the body. My ear is the part and parcel of my body. It has got a specific position in this. Similarly, every living entity has got a specific position in relationship with Krishna. Now, at the present moment, we are covered. We do not know what is our relationship. But as we make advance in Krishna consciousness and we develop, oh, I have got this relationship with my Krishna. As a friend, as a conjugal lover, as a paternal relationship, master and servant, so many, just like we have got experience. And that is called Swarup Siddhi. Swarup Siddhi means perfection of one's original constitutional position. Swarup Siddhi. That we shall realize. As we make advance in the Krishna consciousness, so we graduate. Just like a man with a disease, and as he is being cured by treatment, he gets gradually his healthy condition. He can feel, yes, I am feeling well, and now I am feeling hunger, now I am taking food nicely. Yes, I am getting some strength. Similarly, as we make progress in the matter of Krishna consciousness, then our original constitutional position becomes revealed. And as soon as we fully revealed and free from all these material obligations, my place is without them. Thank you very much.